beautiful wild side, which is fun, but sometimes it can be a little bit risque. But the thing about it, the clothes are sexy and fun, but they're also wearable.
In addition to his fall collection, Todd Oldham recently created a limited edition line of hand-painted lingerie, with all the proceeds going to a shelter for homeless people with AIDS. For VH1 Inside Fashion, I'm Jeanne Beker.
I don't know much about fashion, but I know something about human beings, and she's great.
Respect for a tradition. In New York, the stars come out for Grace Mirabella.
I think Grace has done a brilliant job at understanding women's psyches, that fashion is not about clothes, but of the human spirit.
He's got a phenomenal eye, and he's very erudite. The combination is terrific as far as I'm concerned.
In Toronto, New York art dealer Ivan Carr.
I need to have a visually heightened experience, and it's usually a work of art that does that.
And the furf lies at Fendi.
Yeah, but half of it was fake.
It was?
Yes, but people don't see the difference, huh?
The fun show of the season, or at least it always promises to be. And when you get a load of these clothes, you understand why. Look at this. Stunning. Look at all these sequins, man. I've been locked down. I've been locked in.
But I always seem to come back again. Usually I work thematically, and I just wasn't interested this time. I think we're really celebrating the individual today. And while the makeup is pretty unified, the hair is all very different, the clothes are very different, we stirred up evening with day, and it's just very much like someone's closet. You just go in, and you know how you look in your closet, it's sort of all the things you like, and maybe it's some pinstripe, maybe it's an old cowboy shirt, and you put them together.
Entertaining, they soothe me.
He's very, very, you know, young and exciting, and he's inspired by very enchanting things, you know, not sort of normal everyday fashion. It's very creative. They're like, his clothes are, it's like art, his clothes.
Clothes are sexy and fun, but they're also wearable. If you really, you know, get in the collection and you take it apart, there 90% of the collection is wearable, but I'd say 10% of it is real risque, but it's fun. But you could wear that too, it just depends on where.
I think some element, the pieces themselves are very much real life, you know, like the hat with the big ball on it, this big, you might not want to wear in real life, but the suit that it's with is perfectly normal.
Todd's got great energy, and he's a lot of fun to be around, and it just he picks people to be around him who have that kind of energy, I think, mm-hmm. who are fun and who want to have a great time and who are a little kooky, you know, a little, you know, crazy, but are in therapy.
Coming up on FT, in London, designer Bella Thru.
Maybe doing some fake furs this season.
But the other half of it was fake.
It was?
Yes, but people don't see the difference, huh?
Since 1964, Karl Lagerfeld has designed for Fendi, a fashion house which is also known as one of the world's most exclusive furriers. That's made Fendi a prime target for the anti-fur movement, which last year invaded the runway, branding Lagerfeld's client the criminals of the fashion world. Some of Lagerfeld's favorite mannequins have also joined the anti-fur movement. This photo session was part of a recent poster campaign of supermodels who prefer their own skin to an animal's. For those with the same convictions, but in need of something warmer, Fendi now offers some synthetic options.
I don't know if it will please me, but I'm sure it will please a lot of people that feel very, maybe not concerned, but terrorized, you know, by the sort of moment there is about real fur. I think it's nice because everyone can be happy. It's up to you.
Kiss me to make the lights go out. I'm burning in the morning to make them jump and shout. She's my little baby, sweet as she can be. And all this love she got, it belongs to me. If you hear me howling, call it on my darling, saying, ooh, ooh, ooh.
Her, she used her power to introduce readers to some new talent on the American fashion scene.
She was the editor-in-chief when I received my history-making cover of Vogue magazine in August 1974. It was from her inspiration and her insight
that art, basically, when she was at Vogue. And I owe her so much for that.
She really championed American design. And in her years of with Mirabella, I think she's championed, she's gone beyond American design and really into what is great American style.
If you want me, I am yours.
This celebration was especially sweet because recent gossip had it that Murdoch was about to pull the plug on the not hugely profitable publication. But once again, the cynics were wrong as Grace Mirabella's magazine career moves into its fifth decade.
If I'm known for anything at all, it will probably be for my interest in a certain reality and interest in women and kind of attempting to give them back a book that they deserve.
That's it for this edition of Fashion Television. I'm Jeanne Beker.
Hotel accommodations in New York provided by the Royalton.
And now we return to our regularly scheduled programming. Music. Stay with us and trip the light fantastic to the sounds of pop music's most talented artists. The latest and greatest music videos coming up next.